Hi everyone. So finally, today is going to be... What is it going to be? Okay. Hi everyone. Okay, so I've been getting so many requests for the past few months, for the past year, asking, you know, me to do vlogs, but I've been lazy and I've had this fear against cameras for some reason, although I'm someone who's constantly in front of a freaking camera. I've just been like avoiding it. But finally it's come to a point where I feel like there's things to share that you might like, that somebody else might like. So today is going to be our very first vlog. I'm still waiting for the guys to come down. You know, Johan takes a year to get dressed. So I'm just waiting for them to come down with the bags, you know, get the luggage in. And the plan is for us to go to Norelia. And then once we get to Norelia, the next day we'll be traveling to Knuckles to see someone very special to me. And also, I still have not come up with like a name for the vlog. So if you have any suggestions, feel free to inbox me and let me know. And maybe we can decide something together. Very, very excited.
ඒ කියන්නේ කොත්තර තිබ්බත් අර නැති එක පස්සෙම තමයි.
You just leave me.
I was so Let's see Allah.
I saw Pam 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 p
you're here to see the show. Calling all my demons now to let me go. I need something, give me something wonderful. I believe she won't take me somewhere I'm not supposed to be. You can't steal the things that God has given me. No more pain and no more shame and misery. You can't take me down. You can't break me down. You can't take me down.
Good morning, guys. So day two. Last night we checked in, crashed, no vlogging, nothing. We ate and we slept like pigs. I did not have a good night's sleep because I was freaking out. I do not operate well in new environments. I feel like there are ghosts everywhere. I mean, look at it. It's just so horror movie, you know, suitable type of atmosphere over here. But it's really nice and comfortable. I'm going to show you guys around. I'll show you the room. And okay. The boys
are here.
Boys are here, obviously. Hello. And look at the mess. This is all courtesy of Johan Cepeda. This is all Johan Cepeda. This is Gaya Kurutoku. This is Johan Cepeda. All of this Johan Cepeda. True or false?
False. False.
So this is what I need to deal with in the next few, in the next hour. Cover this. I'm trying to connect to this stupid internet.
Connect.
You like share that struggle with me? Don't you say that as a influencer, a content creator, huh?
The Wi-Fi struggle.
Yeah, man. Okay, it's working. Yay!
Got me on my knees, Layla, begging, darling, please, Layla, darling, won't you ease my worries?
How many hours a day do you spend on your clients?
I break it up. So usually when I do cardio at gym, I respond to my client WhatsApp messages. I spend a couple of hours creating programs, and that's pretty much it. Then the rest of the day, I try to focus on like doing things that will help grow my business, come up with new concepts, strategize, try to calculate my growth, so stuff like that. But it's not every day do I go all out. So certain days I work really hard, certain days I rest a little bit more. So I sort of like gauge my energy levels and then, you know, because I don't want to burn out. We do not want to burn out. the reason behind this whole video vlog, I was trying to find a theme for it myself, but it also stems from like really wanting to get out of like depression, you know, like when you're a depressed person and when you found like ways to come out of it, especially for me, like working on a meditation, and the moment you go back into it, it feels much bigger. It feels like the entire world is, you know, crashing down on you and you really want out. Like I was contemplating on like death and how everything is unpredictable and impermanent, and you know, we are surrounded by pain and suffering and oh my gosh, I don't want to be here anymore, that whole trip. But it was like a pivotal moment in my life because I feel like it really changed who I am, my perception. I was less of an asshole to people because when I work a lot, I get stressed out, and if people around me work slow, even if Johan works slower than I do, even if my assistant is slower than I am, I get mad and I tend to be snappy and bitchy, and that's the person I do not want to be. So this, you know, this contemplation on how short life could be and I could lose you in 2 seconds makes me want to be nicer to you, you know. So that whole path connected me to Sadhu. I met him last year, and you know how you go into nature and it's like a complete reset. Like you stay in this natural pool of water and you step out and you feel like, oh my god, I'm like totally new person. That's how I feel every time I see him. Like his vibration, it was just such an, I don't know, so next level. He was sort of trying to teach me the concept of vipassana. It's a type of meditation where it's all about seeing reality as it truly is. So a few days later, this death happened, and then, you know, then I was in so much pain that I started practicing vipassana, and it really changed me to a point where I say, I'm hot-tempered, Johan is hot-tempered, we end up fighting over like dumb shit. And even those small things sort of went away, which is like I could tolerate anyone, anything, any circumstance, and I felt totally unaffected. But that whole experience was like triggered by trauma because I was in pain, I want to get out of it, so I got into meditation. But when I got comfortable again, I lost touch, and again I was in this crazy monkey like space of just like talking the most negative shit into existence, and you know, that whole trip. So that made me you know, realize that it has to be like a permanent thing. I need to practice this permanently. I need to wake up in the morning 5 o'clock, be disciplined, do my part, do my work, so then I can actually, you know, expect results. Otherwise I'm like, I can't be doing the same shit and expect different results. It's just dumb. So I want to surround my, you know, life or be close to people like that, so I can feed off the energy and be like them. So that's the whole trip about. So there are like 4 or 5 monks, if I'm not mistaken. My teacher is from Siberia. He has very interesting past and story. Maybe I'll try to talk about that with him tomorrow to get some interesting information. But right now we're going to go by the dry rations, because whenever we go there, I think it's very important that we help them on their journey, because what they're doing is like super amazing.
Got me on my knees, Leela.
What did you get, Johan? Did you get anything for yourself?
Yeah, I got myself 2 of these and a book.
So right about now, we're going to go to this gym called Rocky Gym, which is right next to the cinema here in the New Delhi town. We do not know what the condition of the gym is like. Our hotel guys told us that it's kind of dodgy and it's going to be very crowded. So fingers crossed, hopefully we'll be able to get in a workout. It's 7:30 right now, so we have 2.5 hours left. I'm nervous. So let's go and check it out.
Why are you nervous?
I'm nervous because you don't know the dodgy gym. You know? What if it's like all...
Yeah. Woo. Check. Yeah. Jesus be the icon living. Pilgrim be the label, and we ain't about religion. Yeah. Picking up the pen and the pattern and the number, the checking, and as a matter of fact, I just might get out of the valley to the heights. Yeah. Ride to the beat, take a flight. Yeah. In the limelight, make a sprite. Yeah. I do that when life giving me lemons. Y'all can have the wood, I'm never jealous. Yeah, I've been moving through it to the heavens. Yeah, you ain't gotta give me 20 questions. Talk about a lot of nothing but such divine intervention. Like, wow.
So the next plan is to go stuff our faces with some good food because we're extremely hungry. We didn't have a cup of lunch, right?
No.
No, we had like a piece of cake and a cup of coffee. So now we're gonna go have some real food.
21, I wanna be wild. I pass up on a handy circle, little like a penny. I'ma pull you to a semi.
I think we've come pretty close to the location. I think probably 5 to 10 minutes away. I've messaged him. He said just come down or come up the road and he'll be making his way towards us, and then we'll meet halfway and sort of hike together. That's the plan.
Sunny. Oh my god.
My music of elation. Take me to the heights.
And also, like many of the
I can soar.
The whole point of this lifestyle is that whatever you do, it's hard not to be mindful. Whether because you'll end up stepping on a snake or just because there's not many distractions. And it's always at the back of your mind. And that's the whole point.
Yeah.
Mindfulness is not like something you have to keep doing. Like, I'm mindful. Mindfulness is just something you shouldn't be forgetting. Doesn't matter how much you remember it, as long as it's not completely forgotten, that's more than enough.
You get sick. You gotta keep back your mind that you could.
Put this mushroom in,
okay,
and it starts feeding on caffeine and sugar, and it creates this. It's almost like I was basically scratching the itch so much that it's becoming numb. Everything was becoming numb.
And how old were you?
16.
Wow.
I joke, but yeah, in Serbia we were kind of growing up a bit quicker, I think.
Yeah.
Probably a bit, maybe because of the war or whatever. But yeah, by the time I was 16, I was already fed up. Just, what's the point?
So nothing traumatic happened to you to push you to it?
No, absolutely not. Absolutely not. But that's the whole thing. Nothing needs to happen to you. All you need to do is start thinking.
Mm.
And you realize, well, you are liable.
Yeah.
What could happen to you? Nothing happens, but it could, because it happens to other people.
Right.
So then obviously you turn to sensuality, you just scratch every itch as it arises, and that doesn't last. It quickly just...
Did you see like the impermanence of things through that?
Well, that was kind of the first, is like, oh, well, nothing's important, so just do whatever you want, literally. So I was doing whatever I wanted for about a year.
Yeah.
And yeah, and that's, you realize, that's how depression sets in. When you just, well, you've done whatever you wanted, and nothing makes you happy anymore. So then I thought, oh, well, maybe I should say no to myself a bit. I got into meditation and started saying no and giving up smoking, drinking, partying, all that stuff, calming down, and then simultaneously going to the library and just taking books of meditation, whatever it was. And that's how I came across the suttas. The library happened to have a Theravada Sutta translation book.
So if you want to learn Buddhism, that's where you should start, is it?
Well, I think that's the best, because whatever you start, it's not going to be perfect, because, you know, it's been so long since the Buddha. But it's going to be hard, because they're quite condensed in meaning. Yeah, so... People usually read them as some sort of folklore or some sort of old inspirational stories. Mm. But they're actually the most accurate description of your present experience as it is right now. And if you were to fully understand it, you would be free from suffering. We are intoxicated with life, with youth, with health.
Mm.
Intoxicated means you take it for granted, and that's the threshold. That's the basis on account of which you live your life.
Mm.
So when that gets put in question through having somebody die or your life threatened, that's when you realize how divorced your perception of what your life is from what actually life is.
Yeah.
And that's what I mean, like meditation should be bracing you for that, developing clarity and understanding, because that's the only way out. Not like, oh, I'm bothered by this, so I'm just going to learn how to concentrate on my belly or something, and I go into this mystical state where I don't think about anything, and that was just going to make you not think about anything.
Yeah.
But that's not freedom.
Yeah.
The only way... to escape anything that bothers you is first through accepting it and then actually becoming stronger than it. That's the way I kept comparing. The one who meditates rightly becomes like a mountain. It doesn't move against the wind, against the rain. Nothing moves it. But that's not given to you. The strength is developed. There's any other principle of strength.
Yeah.
safe and we'll be in touch.
Thank you.
Take care.
This trip has been interesting. Like every single time I come here, it's always been to run away from some problem, but this time I came just to sort of experience, and I realized like spirituality and like growth and understanding doesn't come in this one magical moment of like this peak energy release during meditation. You feel the kundalini. It's not really that. It's all about practicing every day, you know, restraining and being aware and being mindful. And it's a grind every single day, just like we grind to make money. I think we need to grind to develop spiritually, and that's what I learned this time. I guess that's the conclusion of episode one. If you all like this type of material, this type of content, make sure you inbox me and let me know what you think. And also let me know of a good name for the blog. So until next time, be safe and stay happy.